YouTube!
Alright, so today I'm gonna do a video that's long overdue. So today I'm going to go ahead and go through all my camera gear and show you guys what I've been working with for basically the past year. I haven't really changed my setup at all. I did go from, I used to have the GoPro 3 Plus is when I started my YouTube channel, and now I have the GoPro 4 Black Edition, which I'll be showing in case you don't know what a GoPro 4 Black looks like. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and start. This video is being filmed on my Canon T2i. I have I believe it's an 8mm fisheye lens on there. I think it's a Rokinon lens. I don't use it that much because it's basically the same kind of look as the GoPro. So, you know, sometimes it's nice if you want to get solid audio, but other than that, I don't use that lens very often. The lens that I use for pretty much everything that I do, all the filming, is my Canon 75 to 300mm lens right there. I use this for basically everything. When you're shooting on a Canon T2i, it has a crop sensor of, I believe it's 1.4 times. So anything, if you're shooting, if this says 75mm, you're shooting at 75mm, it should really be, what is that, 100% or 100mm. Pretty much my favorite lens to use. It's got a lot of variety. If you need to go wide, you can use a GoPro, or you can pop on the 17 to 55mm lens that should come with the T2i. And then I also have a Canon 50mm lens. It's the 1.8. I do a lot of time lapses with this 50mm lens. It really gets that nice cinematic look. It's an out of focus background, really sharp focus. But yeah, this one's a really fun one to shoot with. Obviously not much variety. If you need to, you know, if you want to change your shot, move forward or back, it's, you know, you just got to walk forward or back. No variety here, but creates an amazing shot. I always got extra batteries. I'm using the hand grip on the bottom of the T2i, so you can pop two batteries in there at a time. It usually lasts me when I'm filming around 2 to 3 hours, and then you just pop two more of these in and it's another 2 to 3. So I really never run out of batteries, just with three extras and two in the camera. Always carry an extra GoPro battery in my case. I really never use it because every time I go out filming with my GoPro, it usually uses pretty much just an entire battery right away. Or not right away, throughout the entire session. Of course, this is the GoPro 4 Black Edition with a Host DV mouth mounts. And what I did with the floaty back door is I cut a little hole in here so you can bring the mouth mount down as much as you want, and it really rests on your chin and it absorbs any types of like bumps or turbulence that you may be using it. I got my tripod here. I believe it's a Manfrotto. There's no name on it. I stand corrected. It's a Ravelli AVT Professional 67-inch video camera tripod fluid drag head. It's that thing I've had for 2.5 years now, and obviously the buckles down here are rusted with salt water, so these things don't work anymore because it's been in the water so much. But been in the water for what, two to three years? Haven't had any issues with it. Having a good tripod with a ball bearing head really makes a world's difference. Other than that, that's pretty much my camera setup. I have a Mac desktop here that I use to cut some of the raw footage. I mainly use my laptop, which is a 2007 MacBook Pro, for everything. That's where I have all my programs on it. I use Final Cut Pro 7. I use a plugin called Twixter for the slow motion. All my other plugins are on that computer. I also have Photoshop, Lightroom, Adobe After Effects. I use Photoshop quite often. So that's pretty much it for my gear. I like to keep it simple and lightweight. If there's anything that I may have forgotten or that you guys would like to see, because this is my first video doing this, go ahead and comment down below and I could possibly make another video for that. Other than that, thank you guys for watching. Yeah. Yeah.